Thank you for coming. Ms. Lucinda Merritt. Nearly, I haven't seen that fence start yet, but I need to get with it.
I was thinking, you know, it's not so much fence, it's just not where I'm at, but conservation and stopping permits.
Thanks, Lucinda Merritt. I normally speak for the Asian Chutney Alliance, but I'm not doing that right now. I'm just speaking as a private person who lives in Fort White near Rome Island, about a mile back from the San Fe River. I too have seen the changes, and I do am concerned, as you all know. But I want to pick up a little bit on what Jim Hagum and Marilee said about our laws and our legal structure, and this idea of the public interest that's part of the three-pronged test that actually hasn't been defined. I have a copy, and I think I sent this link to Hugh, of an article in The Guardian from December 5th about Nestle cannot claim bottled water is, quote, essential public service. And I want to just read a couple of excerpts from that, just as an FYI. I don't want to put Nestle on trial, but I want you all to hear some of this. Michigan's second highest court has dealt a legal blow to Nestle's Ice Mountain Water brand, ruling that the company's commercial water bottling operation is not an essential public service or a public water supply. The appellate judges acknowledged that water was essential to life, but wrote that the context in which water is sold also had to be considered. Marketing bottled water in an area where tap water is available is unessential. This is a court saying this. This is not me. The circuit court's conclusion that Nestle's commercial water bottling operation is an essential public service is clearly erroneous, the judges wrote, other than in areas where no other source of water, bottled water, is not essential. The judges also disagreed with Nestle's argument that it represented a public water supply. They said state law unambiguously implies public water supplies are conveyed to a site where pipes called non-essential water is provided in bottles. We conclude that Nestle's proposed booster pump facility is not a public water supply under Michigan law. And then finally, Nestle extracting water and sending it to other places where it cannot return to the water table, and critically, doing so faster than the aquifer can replenish, is an irretrievable depletion unless the pumping is reduced or halted, the judges wrote. I think one of the central questions here is a legal one, and the way I phrase it is it in the public interest to prioritize private profits over the existence of a priceless and irreplaceable part of Mother Nature? Merrilee has cited a lot of laws that apply to what you all do here. I'm not sure, and I'm not a lawyer, but I'm not sure that any of them are sufficient to give you the clout that you need to deny permits like this without getting involved in a lot of lawsuits and legal back and forth, which I've been involved with through the nonprofit I work for, and frankly, I'm sick of it. And so I would like to ask you, if you all really care, and I believe you do, about preserving our springs and preserving water security for all of us and our natural systems, work with us and help us work with our legislature to beef up these laws so that it gives you the power that you need to deny things like this permit and to preserve our springs, the largest concentration of freshwater springs in the world. This board is not powerless. The people in this room are not powerless, but I think we need to put our heads together and come up with some better laws than what we have right now that are more effective in preserving these things so that we don't always have to have these same conversations. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Gilbert Gilchrist.